This problem involves a consideration of the stoichiometric relationship that's going to allow us to determine the concentration of one of the reactants exiting the reactor for butadiene hydrogenation. And we specifically want to know what will be the concentration of hydrogen exiting the reactor when the conversion of the limiting reactant, which is butadiene in this case, is 75%. To set up this problem, we're going to need to be able to express the concentration of component B, and I'm going to label these components as A and B for our two reactants, A being butadiene and B being hydrogen. And so we're interested in the concentration of component B. We can express that in terms of the molar flow rate of B exiting the reactor over the total volumetric flow rate exiting the reactor. And so we just need to express each of these in terms of conversion. Okay, and so we'll do that out to the right here. The molar flow rate of B exiting the reactor in terms of conversion is just equal to the flow rate of B into the reactor, so what we start with, minus that which is consumed by reaction. And we're keeping track in this case of the conversion of butadiene, and so in terms of the conversion of butadiene, we can multiply that conversion by the moles of butadiene that we feed. All right, so that's minus FA naught times X. That gives us the moles of butadiene that are reacted. All right, and when we plug in the initial feed rate and the conversion of 75%. And then for every mole of butadiene that's reacted, we react 2 moles of hydrogen based on the stoichiometry. And so we need to place a 2 here. This is our basic expression for FB. In terms of the volumetric flow rate, we're going to relate that to the inlet volumetric flow rate for the reactor. That will be equal to, assuming ideal gas behavior, the total flow rate over the inlet total flow rate times the inlet pressure over the outlet pressure. This is a proportionality that comes straight from the ideal gas law, and we're assuming constant temperature in this reaction. If we start plugging in for this expression, what we can see is that the total flow rate is equal to the total flow rate that we start with, and then we need to account for how the total flow rate changes with reaction. For each mole of A that's reacted, we will be on net consuming 2 total moles of stuff. So we have 3 moles on the reactant side of our expression, and 1 mole on the product side of our expression. And so each time a mole of A reacts, we lose 2 total moles of stuff. We can write this in terms of a minus 2 times FA naught times X. So now we've expressed that in terms of conversion. All right, then we need to put it in terms of this ratio that's shown in the equation above. And so FT over FT naught is going to be equal to 1 minus 2 times FA naught over FT naught, which is the mole fraction of A in the feed times the conversion. We are given information on what YA naught is. The feed contains 30% butadiene, and so ultimately we can plug in a value of 0.30 here. Now we just need to plug in information on P naught over P, and we're given that the initial pressure is 3 bar. And the pressure drop is 1 bar, so the final pressure is 2 bar. Now we can come back to our original expression that was right here and plug in the results that we have so far. And if we do that, then we will get the concentration of B. And now I'm going to factor out an FA naught from the expression right here for FB. And so I'll get an FA naught times FB naught over FA naught minus 2x. And then this is all over our volumetric flow rate, V naught, times 1 minus 2 times YA naught times P naught over P. We can then realize that this quantity is equal to CA naught, and FV naught over FA naught is equal to 7/3, given the problem statement, which is that we have 30% butadiene and 70% hydrogen. The conversion is 75%, and we've talked about the values for the other parameters. And so that means that all we need to do in order to fully specify the problem is to solve for the concentration of A initially, and CA0 we can express in terms of the mole fraction of A initially times the initial pressure over RT. Temperature in this case is equal to 400 Kelvin. And then in convenient units for this problem statement, the value of R is approximately 0.083 in units of bar, liter, moles, and Kelvin. So this will give us the concentration in units of moles per liter. Finally, if we just plug those numbers in directly here for CA0, done everything we need to do to solve for the concentration of B. And so what I get for the concentration of B is then 0.027 moles per liter.